足はバッキー。お前を超えるため。俺の首を狙う剣士を俺の手で育てろというのか。猛者の戯れ。
Hey, hey, my dear pirates. And in today's video, we're going to talk about our dear samurai, Roronoa Zoro. Will Zoro have an epic fight and a win against some big opponent? After all, for many One Piece fans, Zoro, even though he is very powerful, still hasn't really shown that he deserves to become the greatest swordsman in the world. Many believe that Zoro still hides a special power, and that when this power is revealed, then Zoro can be raised as one of the greatest swordsmen in the world, coming closer to Shanks and Mihawk. But what would that special power be? Could it be something related to his right eye? Well, some believe so and claim that Mihawk is behind it. Want to understand this story better? Well, that's what we're going to talk about in today's video, but first of all, so if you want to be a pirate king like me and achieve eternal glory, go ahead and press the like button with all the power of your devil fruit, and if you're new here, my dear sailor, already subscribe to the channel and don't forget to activate the notifications bell so you don't miss any new video from Anime Joy Boy, okay? Then join this crew that will dominate the entire Grand Line and the New World. Now without further ado, let's get to this epic video. And well, my dear pirate, One Piece is an anime that certainly has a huge variety of strong and surprisingly powerful characters in its plot. And while its protagonist, Monkey D. Luffy, has had more evolutions and has been more often used to make comparisons related to the power of other One Piece characters, it's Zoro who is always in the second tier when these comparisons are made. Well, that's wrong, as Zoro is perhaps the second most powerful character in the Straw Hats gang. So any power comparison that doesn't take Luffy or some of his supernova allies like Kid and Law into account ends up getting worse. Zoro appears as the character to be compared when we look at secondary characters from other crews. A great example of what I'm saying here is the Mighty King. King fought Zoro in Wano Country and ended up losing to the swordsmen of Luffy's crew. It was a very difficult battle in which Zoro didn't have much of a chance due to King not only being very powerful, but also being a Lunar and having unique abilities, not to mention the power of his ancestral Zoan. Still, against all odds, Zoro managed to defeat King and thus proved that he is the stronger of the two. However, even so, even with all this comparison, many believe that Zoro has not yet demonstrated everything that is expected of him. After all, since he trained with Mihawk, who is one of the most powerful characters in One Piece, Zoro was expected to be much more powerful. Many believe that Zoro should be closer to Luffy's power level, and therefore, he should not only defeat King, but also defeat one of the Yonko, which could be Big Mom. Well, I understand that many Zoro fans get frustrated at times with the character. After all, as much as he is the character created with the intention of being someone large, we have to understand that Oda sometimes likes to play with these things. Just because a character has a badass style doesn't mean that appearing to have the power to defeat anyone who appears in front of him doesn't mean he will in fact do it. Negative, my dear sailor, Oda likes to subvert our expectations whenever possible. And with Zoro, it's the same thing, making Zoro lose a seamlessly easy fight or making a weak character the key part of a battle is something Oda loves to do. So I don't believe that Zoro is weaker just because he didn't win a Yonko or because he lost a lot of fights, and no, I don't think that the victory over King is something that shouldn't be taken into consideration. Sometimes I think the fans, especially Zoro fans, tend to have a very wrong view of the character, and because of this distorted view, these fans end up not seeing the value that this important character has. Zoro is to Luffy what Silver's Rayleigh was to Roger. He is important and will have his epic moment, and no, the fight against King was not Zoro's pinnacle. Not even his epic feat of cutting Kaido was in fact his epic moment. I believe Oda has something in store for Zoro, but it will be however Oda sees fit. Many believe that his fight against Mihawk, his possible final fight, will give Zoro all his glory, and I believe that too. But before that moment, I believe we will have something relatively as grand as this moment. What many miss is Oda's ability to shock and thrill us. So Zoro will still have such a grand moment that it will make his victory against King or his attack on Kaido become something our minds don't even remember anymore. I'm talking about something unique here. Yes, my dear sailor, I believe that Oda has something unique and special prepared for Zoro, and when the time is right, he will reveal that to us. And yes, it has to do with his scars and his true power. I should already say that it may happen that Zoro's car is something just to make an allusion to Rayleigh, since, as said before, Zoro is the representation of Rayleigh in the Straw Hat's gang. But I have my doubts about that. Yes, Oda likes to play with these allusions and similarities between characters, but in Zoro's case, I believe that these things will be different. The scar does have the meaning of alluding to another character, but it also has the potential to do something more, and I explain why. Since the beginning of One Piece, there have been several moments where Zoro's power was mentioned to have some relation to something special and demonic, something that was outside the reality of the world. Of course, everything can be a figure of speech. Like I said, Oda loves playing with these things. However, in the fight against Kaku, things are different. The CP9 member clearly says he saw a demon in Zoro again, and it was amazing how Zoro managed to show, in a visible way, his fighting aura in the form of a demonic being, in this case, Ashura. And in the fight against King, the Straw Hat swordsman used the King of Hell 3-sword style to finally cut the skin and defeat King. The technique shows Enma draining his stores of Conqueror's weaponry and haki before imbuing both of them into his 3 swords, creating far more powerful and far-reaching attacks. Zoro's encounter with King during the Onigashima segment of One Piece's Wano arc is arguably his most iconic fight. The commander of the Beast's pirate put on a fantastic fight, being a fantastic blend of the series' classic approach to humor, action, and suspense and storytelling in general. Easily the most exciting development, however, was Zoro's awakening of not just standard Conqueror Haki, but advanced Conqueror Haki as well. It allows the user to apply their standard Haki to their limbs or weapons, as seen in the recently completed Luffy vs. Kaido fight from the manga. The technique is even rarer than standard Conqueror Haki, but it is used by some of the biggest names in the series: Goldie, Roger, Big Mom, Kaido, Whitebeard, and Yamato. Not only Luffy, but Zoro is also part of this list now. After defeating his enemy, Zoro says he'll even become the King of Hell to keep his promise to Luffy never to lose again. This is a reference to his sword Enma, named after the Japanese Buddhist King of Hell in the sex myths. East Asian sects of Buddhism have a similar deity called Yama, of which Enma is the Japanese version. Being the Buddhist deity, the naming of Enma as his sword and the King of Hell as his new style with said sword matches the Buddhist themes of Zoro's character. In the fight against Kaido, Zoro uses everything he has in his Ashura and attacks the Yonko, leaving a huge scar on his body. And once again, we can see his aura taking a dark and frightening shape. Do you realize that everything in Zoro is related to something mythical, demonic, and even divine? Well, here I come back to the part where many say that Zoro's apex will be his fight against Mihawk, but Mihawk is his master. I doubt that Zoro, when the time comes, will fight to kill Mihawk and thus have Yoru for himself. No, in the past video, I said that I believed that Zoro would win it after beating Mihawk, but not in a battle, but as a form of respect shown by the former Shichibukai. That's why I believe that the moment Zoro will shine will be in an epic fight, but not against Mihawk, but in the last war before we get to Laugh Tale. But Mihawk does matter at that moment. I believe that in an important fight, probably against an admiral, Zoro will release his true power, and so he will have a flashback. At that moment, all his training with Mihawk will be revealed, where he discovers Zoro's hidden power. So Mihawk decides to seal it, this power, in his left eye, so that when Zoro really achieves perfect control of his haki, and also after reaching the apex of physical and mental power, Zoro would finally be ready to unleash his power, whether that power is something demonic or not. And I say this because it's funny how everyone Zoro fought who had a devil fruit or observation haki could see this demonic aura in him. So, Kaku's line might make some sense as to Zoro actually having a demonic power, and even though it's just a figure of speech, it's still clear to me that Zoro has great potential to be explored, and this could be linked to his master, Dracul Mihawk, and his left eye scar. This, for me, would be the best way to explain Zoro's scar. Of course, if there really is something mysterious about it. Also explain why many characters see this demonic aura in Zoro, and of course, this would be the best way to give Zoro everything your most assiduous fans want. An epic moment! But now I want to know your opinion about everything that we commented here today. Will we ever have the truth behind Zoro's scar? Did Mihawk seal some hidden power into Zoro? Or did Zoro already have a special power that needed to be controlled? And what will this revelation be like? Will it only be at the end of One Piece in a flashback? But of course, if you made it this far, it's because you like the content, so it doesn't hurt to subscribe to our channel and become one more member of our fleet, my dear sailor. And of course, do not forget to press the like button, that helps a lot in spreading the video and the channel. So help us to become the largest fleet of pirates here on YouTube, okay? A big hug for everyone, and until the next video.